much for giving me this chance to make my presentation. First of all, to ASA and then to Pakistan Academy of Science. I will try to share my idea about the role of social finance in achieving the objectives of sustainable development goals. As you know, nowadays, really we are in a time that we need to reconsider again the sustainability and sustainable development goals. This is my presentation outline. And I, as you know, sustainable development is involves a concept that incorporates meeting the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. And in 2015, a new global development agenda was introduced to achieve 17 sustainable development goals by the year of 2030. The realization of these goals would improve the socio-economic issues like education, water and public health, fight injustice and inequalities, eradication of poverty and hunger, responsibility in production and consumption. As Istanbul Sabahattin Zaim University this year, according to Times Higher Education ranking, we are in top 200 among the world universities. One was on our research and publications, and our system made contribution for reducing the poverty. And the second one is the responsible consumption and production issue. And we are very proud about this. As you know, funds needed to achieve these sustainable development goals are extremely large. Therefore, joint efforts are very crucial for this purpose. Governmental commitments alone towards achieving sustainable development goals would not be sufficient. Comprehensive implementation of Islamic social finance institutions in their modern context can make contribution positively in achieving these sustainable development goals. As you know, essentially in the economy, there are three main sectors: public, private, and WACF sector. And as the tools in social finance, you know, sadaka, zakat, infaq, kard al-hasan, and WACF institutions are historically constructed models in Islamic economics to provide public goods and social welfare. To explore the main perspectives in which Islamic social finance can play a role in achieving sustainable development goals. In addition to private and public government sector, WACF sector as a third sector is very crucial. From our civilization, we have very huge heritage, and we can use this heritage to solving some problems in present world. To examine the efforts of zakat, sadaka, infaq, kard al-hasan, microfinance, and WACF, FKAF in the realization of SDGs. When we look at the literature review, Islamic social finance is one of the most popular topics among academicians while finding solutions to the modern socio-economic issues. The institution of zakat is mainly used to solve socio-economic problems and to promote sustainable agriculture in northern Nigeria. The institution of WACF is considered to be more effective for poverty alleviation programs in many countries and even surpasses the government contribution in Bangladesh. Infaq involves spiritual dimensions in addition to its economical contribution to sustainable development goals. The role of Islamic social finance tools play a vital role in achieving sustainable development, because they are like the zakat, efkaf, and infaq. And when we look at the zakat, as you know, it is one of the five pillars of Islam. And every time in the Quran, nowadays we are in the Ramadan, it's together with salah, salah and zakat. And there is no any division. So the main pillar is salah, and very close to that is zakat. It means the purification or increase. And a Muslim must purify his wealth by paying zakat as long as he or she owns the required thresholds nisab. Zakat is to achieve at least 7 goals out of 17 SDGs. Reduction of poverty via zakat collection and redistribution. For instance, Sheikh and Ismail provide a statistical study indicating that only 7 individual persons have as much wealth as bottom 50% of entire global population. Their combined wealth is $426 billion as of end of 2016. And day by day, this injustice is increasing. As per World Bank, there are 767 million people below the poverty line of less than $2 per day. It means that poverty gap is very high, and comparing the wealth owned by the only richest 7 persons and the total global poverty gap funding requirement, and hence zakat being of one main tools for wealth redistribution, can contribute positively to poverty reduction. Ending hunger via zakat, this could be achieved by using zakat to ensure food security for poor people through poverty alleviation programs, ensuring healthy lives and promoting well-being via zakat, empowering quality of the education via zakat, empowering the gender quality via zakat, using zakat for preventing environment from degradation. Environment serves in several humanitarian needs, including source of energy, firewood for cooking, and others. Around 65% of households depend on firewood for cooking purpose in the state of Kano in Nigeria. Zakat funds create income for poor people and enable them to purchase gas for cooking activities instead of firewood or charcoal. Last 3 of zakat recipients are directly related to the SDGs, al-fukara, al-masakin, and fi sabilillah class, you know. Indonesia, the larger Muslim majority country, zakat is formally collected and distributed through the state zakat authority called Basnas. It is estimated that this institution has the potential to contribute an amount up to 32 billion yearly, equivalent to 3.4% of Indonesian GDP in 2016. Basnas via zakat institutions in Indonesia introduce programs that always address 5 main fields. Calculations show that in between 3 and 7% of GDP can be considered as zakat. There are some estimations for 7 different countries. One of them is Turkey. And we are facing that there is a huge potential. We can use zakat for to realize some SDGs goals. There are social sector, education, economic, health, and dawah, zakat can play a role. A second institution, when you look at the waqf, evkaf, institution, Vakf is the fact of keeping a property from the consumption of its original owner, while the benefits derived from property are given to the needy and poor people, keeping the capital in the same form. Vakf is an indispensable instrument in the agenda of SDGs, particularly in Muslim majority countries, where the assets of the global Vakf is expected to be worth $1 trillion. Rather than zakat, Vakf was used by the Ottomans, by the Ottoman Empire, succeeded in poverty alleviation for about six centuries. Here, I want to share with you that this we prepared a project on Ottoman cash vakfs, nearby 14 volumes, and we have seen that this vakfs played also a very crucial role. We are facing in Ottoman civilization, there are different vakfs, from education to the bird safety, from health to finance. Vakf operates by generating funds from cash donations, microcredit, fixed property, crowdfunding, and other methods of fundraising. After collecting funds from different sources of financing, Vakf institution uses these funds to achieve its goals that are in line with the SDGs. When we look at this figure, you can see that how we can use the Vakf institution to realize these SDGs. And when we look at the infaq, you know, it is again the donate, in addition to donations and zakat, there are sadaqa and also other infaq ways. Infaq is two types, obligatory and voluntary. The former includes zakat, khums, ushur, haraj, and jizya, while the latter comprises institutions such as Vakf, Vasiyya, Sadakas, Kard al-Hasan. Infaq is taken as right assigned by God from the rich people to the poor once, and not just a donation in ordinary sense, as mentioned in the Holy Quran. It has three main pillars, which are economic growth, environmental soundness, and social inclusiveness. Infaq aims at developing sustainable development, human development trends in communities by providing them basic facilities such as education, educating them to become more productive in participating in social activities and economic life. So in when we look at the priorities in with these institutions, we are facing with realism. All of them are support the real economy, and they are realizing the justice, and they are also providing the balance in society. They are, you know, moral, ethical institutions, and you know, all this, you know, in according to Islamic economics, main principles for all humanity. We have to provide the security for nafs, for akl, for nesl, and for envil, for the goods and services, and also for the system, religion. In conclusion, I can say that zakat shows its effectiveness in achieving at least seven goals among the global agenda of SDGs. Vakf and charity, Awqaf, has preceded this global agenda, as it has historically helped and still being used for providing the listed goals in the SDGs, and even more than in Muslim communities. Infaq and sadaqa has the potential to maintain sustainable human development and other factors of SDGs when its three pillars are achieved by communities. Kard al-Hasan, cash vakfs, microfinance can play an important role for the achievement of SDGs. Thank you so much for giving me this chance, and I hope a successful conference.
Thank you, Professor Mehmet.